Our fathers acted proudly. But they and our fathers acted proudly, hardened their necks, and did not heed your commandments. They refused to obey, and they were not mindful of your wonders that you did among them. But they hardened their necks, and in their rebellion they appointed a leader to return to their bondage. But you are God, ready to pardon, forgive, gracious, loving and merciful, slow to anger, abundant in kindness, and did not forsake them. Even when they made a golden calf for themselves, and said, "This is your God that brought you up out of Egypt, and worked great provocations." Yet in your manifold mercies you did not forsake them in the wilderness. Nehemiah 9:16-19. Blessed be your names, O God. Blessed be your holiness and abundant mercies and loving care. Your love personified over and over and over, too many times to number. You are amazing, and that is not the half of it. You are past my understanding, yet in faith, or trust somehow, I believe. My Lord and God, I come to seek knowing more of your great love for us. I need to know more about how high, and how wide, and how deep it is for me. I do believe if I can fully take hold of the magnificence of your love, then all my fears and doubts will be no more as I walk so wonderfully in the glow of your love for me. It will secure me and hold me fast against all the railing and temptations sent against me, then I will not be moved. In Jesus' holy name I come to seek your face and grace, amen. Lord, it is said to taste and see that you are good. I have tasted of your goodness, you are so good. In these scriptures in Nehemiah he expounds on how merciful and long-suffering you were with Israel there in the wilderness. Again, amazing does not cover what you did and who you are. Nehemiah tells of how ugly and hard-headed and rebellious they were, and yet you gave them time, and more time, to repent and return their hearts to you. Even when they called a calf their God, you did not forsake them. Many did die that day that Moses returned from the mountain from meeting with you to get the Ten Commandments, but you preserved those who drew near to Moses. You are very slow to anger for sure. Moses prayed for them and he extended himself to help them, even when at first when you called him he did not want to go. You chose a good man when you called him and prepared him for the rigors of his calling to shepherd your people for so many years. I am so glad that you really know the end from the beginning for each of us. Yes, mercy is your middle name. Lord, when I look back at my own life I can remember when I was stiff-necked too. When I was rebellious in obeying and trusting you. Most of us can say, "Well, I never made a calf and said it delivered me," but I know in my heart that we make others' gods up. We have gods of pleasure, gods of work, gods of prosperity, gods of family or position and title. We make ourselves our own little gods as we believe that we deliver ourselves from our trials and such, we make our own ways. We do not need any other than ourselves. We do again deceive ourselves over and over in this life because we want what we want, and it makes us feel better at the moment to believe what we want to believe. I know that in this life it is too easy to get sidetracked with just getting too busy for being still with you, for waiting for you. That enemy of our souls waits and plots and sets plans in place before our feet hit the floor in the morning to set our paths away from time with you. Thank you, Lord God, that you not only sent your Son Jesus to save us, but you have sent the Holy Spirit to guide us and lead us through this world and to you. I am blessed beyond measure, Lord. Dear Father, I do not want to forget your mercies over me. I do not want to take your blessings for granted. Not even once. I want to always remember your love and forgiveness towards me, your kindnesses and grace covering especially when I have not deserved any of it. You have been so good to me for sure. Very gracious for years. And now too, you watch over me and guard my ways even when I do not ask you, you are there protecting and providing before I can even ask. Father, you have sent good people in my life to be blessings to me and my walk here on earth. People who helped me in different ways and all the ways led to you. Thank you for each and every one of them. and thank you for your watch, care, and tender mercies over my family you gave me too. Thank you. My Lord, I come and praise you today for this Bible again that points me back to you every day. I thank you for giving me the heart I have to believe this Word of God. I thank you for the words today that you are slow to anger, not like us today, so quick to judge and condemn. Please, Lord, we need more of your heart for others in us, less of this flesh and so much more of your Holy Spirit. Please use my life today, Father, to be a light in the darkness around me and to flavor others' lives with your loving mercy too. Lord Jesus, it is in your holy, holy name I bow my spirit to pray. Amen.